Hi, Ipswich, it's me again, Miss Hohenstein, librarian at the Doyon School. Today I'm going to be reading chapter 37 from Catherine Applegate's The Wish Tree. Many in the neighborhood didn't approve of an unmarried Irish woman raising an abandoned Italian baby. People talked, as they will, and they tisk-tisked, as they must. Some people were even angry. They said hurtful things. They told Maeve that Amadora didn't belong. They told Maeve she and the baby should leave. Maeve merely smiled, held Amadora close, and waited and hoped. On dark nights, when hope was scarce, she would sing an old Irish tune mixed with a newer Italian song that she had learned from a neighbor. The melody was sweet, the words were silly, the effect was always the same, a smile from little Amma. Sure enough, the longer Maeve waited, the kinder people grew. And before long, Amma, as she came to be called, was as much a part of our messy garden as all the rest of us. When Amma was old enough to feed Squibbles and his family, she did. When she was strong enough to climb me, she did. And when she was ready to make wishes of her own, she did. Amma grew up steady and honest and kind, like her mother, and had babies of her own, and then grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Eventually, Amma and her husband bought the little brown house and the one right next to it and painted them blue and green. Years later, they purchased a house across the street and began to rent the blue and green houses to other families. The family grew and prospered and argued and failed and loved and laughed. Always and forever, the laughter kept them going. And when Amma's grandson had a little girl, he chose a fine Italian name for her with a fine Irish middle name, Francesca Maeve. Thank you. Bye, Ipswich.